Rob Stone here for Vegas Pro Insiders Daily, and today is August the 8th, and it was literally 14 years ago that I moved into this very house. How about that? So congratulations for me having been here. Won't be here, not to my knowledge, by next year at this time, and certainly sooner, but gonna move down the road to, around here in the Phoenix area. But, you know, hey, it's been a great trip. It's been a wonderful time with all my family here and everything these last 14 years. So it's been all good. And hey, we'll continue to make it happen. And speaking of making it happen, Vegas Pro Insiders Daily membership is available to you. One, the basic membership is $39.99. You can get all of my terrific plays, which have been doing extremely well of late. I want to say 10-4 comes to mind. And so that has done well. And then also, as I've mentioned on this video several times in the last couple of weeks, the Dirty Dog system up 47 units since May, just killing it. So that's something also available. Wise Guys selections, all kinds of stuff. Or you can upgrade that package to $99 and get picks from some of the top handicappers like Kyle Hunter, Sean Higgs, Jim Mack, and I have a new addition which will be coming this week that you'll be hearing about very shortly. So we have that, and that's only $99 a month. Super deal. Okay. So, hey, we got a bunch of free picks and we have a ton of free picks today for you. You know, I think it was last night was the full moon, if I'm not mistaken. Well, you know, it seems like the full moon's going to be tonight because there are so many line moves. Okay. I got seven of them for free picks for you today. Seven. It's crazy. So, hey, let's get it started. New York Yankees, Toronto Blue Jays, first game up. In this AL encounter, Toronto has blossomed from a minus 110 to a minus 125 favorite, and the total has sunk from 9.5 to 9. Now, I completely agree with the total going down. CC Sabathia has been a big surprise all year. He looked like he was Matt Cain last year, absolutely done. But he's come back, done a nice job, and has a solid, 3.81 ERAs, won nine times. And he's going up against J.A. Happ for Toronto. Now, in this game, Sabathia is, I believe, let me think now. 13-4 under when facing teams that average 1.25 or more home runs a game. And Happ, when he's home at night, 16-5 under. So look at this game. I definitely like the under. As far as the side, there's heavy action on Toronto. But you know what? I kind of like the Yankees here. I think they're the better team overall. And when the Yankees are an underdog since 2015 of, I think it's plus 150 or less, they're 9-2. So consider that. I'll take the Yankees also with the under. Next up, we have another American League East game for you. Boston is at Tampa Bay. And the total has gone from 7.5 down to 7. And there's one real easy reason you cannot, keyword here is discount that possibility, because Chris Sale is the Boston Red Sox pitcher. Now, Sale's been terrific all year, but his last outing, he got just absolutely hit hard. I mean, ripped up by the Cleveland Indians. 7 runs in 5 innings. You know what? He's too good. That's not going to happen again. At least you wouldn't think so, right? So I can understand completely why the total would be going down in that instance. But here's the thing, okay? Now, Boston's offense has really been percolating of late, and 6.4 runs per game in their last, 6.5 in their last 8 games. So their offense has been really clicking. And I got a feeling that, I think it can continue down in Tampa Bay, that they can, you know, still score some more runs. And I also like the fact that with a day off yesterday for the Red Sox, they're 10-1 when that occurs, if the game's on the road, which in this case it certainly is. So I'm going to go over that 7, thinking that, you know, Sale's going to have a good game. I would assume not to deny that, but I'm just not sure that that they won't score some runs. So I like the over in that one. Next up, we got 2 interleague games, starting off first in the Midwest, the Milwaukee Brewers and the Minnesota Twins. The Brewers, they blew it last night, had a 4-1 lead, gave it all back and some more, and the Twins won 5-4. So this will be the final game in this series, in this interleague matchup, I should say. Final game, because they're going to go east over to Milwaukee after tonight. Now, the Twins started off as a slight minus 103 underdog, and they are up to minus 120 or more, as baseball bettors have preferred them. Now, Matt Garza, you won't find me under on his Facebook page. Let's just put it that way. I'm no fan of his. I don't think he's a very good pitcher. Hasn't been for years. But lately, hey, you know what? I give him his due. He's got an ERA of just over 2 in his last 5 starts. Most of them have been, you know, minimal innings, under 6 innings for the most part. But, you know, hey, he's doing the job as basically a number 5 starter for the Brewers. So I kind of like the Brewers to get this one done in spite of, you know, the direction of the odds. And the total has also gone up from 9.5 to 10. And even though the Brewers are not hitting of late, playing against American League teams with a slugging percentage of 400 or less, the Brew Crew is 10-0 over. So not strong plays, like the Brewers, like the over in this one. Finally, we got the I-70 series, St. Louis at Kansas City. Last night, the Cardinals just ripped them up. 11-3 was the final score over in KC. And the Cardinals are getting a lot of love. They scored 24 runs in their last 2 games. So people think their offense is hot. And they have taken them also from a minus 103 favorite up to minus 120 to minus 125. Michael Wacha has been terrific in his last 9 starts, I believe an ERA of 1.90. However, his ERA is over 5 when he's pitched on the road, and I think the Cardinals are only 3-5 in those games. Now, he's going up against Jason Vargas, who at the end of June had a 2.22 ERA. In his start since, he's 1-3 with a 6.75 ERA, so that's not very good. But you know what? I have a feeling tonight that Kansas City is going to get it done. Again, this will certainly not be a strong play for me, but I think they're going to be able to beat St. Louis tonight. And then the total, I'm trying to remember now, the total went down. Went from 9 to 8.5. And, you know, there's a few things you can say about Vargas, but generally speaking, I think that's going to be the right direction. So I'll have a lean on the under. So I'll take leans on Kansas City and the under in that contest. So there you go. All 7 plays. Let's hope we can get some more winners. We've been in a pretty good streak. A little bit shaky of late, but overall, over 130 some picks. We've done extremely well. A little over 55%. So that's quite good. And they're free picks. Besides, not like they're premium picks that you can get like being a VPID member. Hey, this is Doug Upstone. August 8th. This is what I got. We look forward to talking to you tomorrow. Take care, and I am out.